Hi, it's me again with CorelDRAW Tips and Tricks, and somebody posted this file, and everybody's already answered it, but they had some confusion about back minus front welding. And here's probably the best example. This red rectangle is in the front, because you can see it. So if you select them both, and you use back minus front, so it's taking the back minus the front, and it's taking away everything that was showing from the front. So the same thing on this wagon wheel that they were trying to do. And what I would suggest is to move the wagon wheel out of the way, the outside wheel and the inside part of the wheel, and just, I've got my nudge factor set on 4 inches, and I'm just going to put it like that. And so I'm going to select all this. I'm going to go back minus front. And then you put this back. And it all depends on what you drew last as the order is in. So let's back up here and get back to the original drawing. And if you open up Windows Dockers, Object Prop Manager, you can see the ellipses I drew first. So these little rectangles that I rotated are on the top, if that makes any sense. So if you drew, well, let's just do this real quick. Let's take our, let's nudge our outside circle out of the way, and you can see our rectangles are on top. If we do back minus front, it does what we want. But let's just back up here, and let's, I'm holding down the shift key, I'm going to grab all the rectangles, and I'm going to move them below the ellipses. Now let's do the exact same thing and back minus front, and it doesn't do what we wanted. It did what Corel you told it to do, but because the ellipses are at the, that it's acting like you drew them first. So if you do it back, hold down the shift, you can grab all the rectangles, and let's just move the rectangles up to there, and now do back minus front. And it works out. And I'm just hitting P and putting it back in the keyboard or in the center of the page. So then when you fill it in, that's what you've got. And also a viewer on that same site, these are all kind of like broken parts. But if you use the Smart Fill tool and fill it in and then move it over and left click, right click. Well, I didn't have to because I have hairline drawn on my Smart Fill tool. Now this is all one piece. So if you grab any part of that, it's all one piece of the wagon wheel. It has welded them together. Anyway, I hope that helped a little bit. Thank you for watching.